प्रेम से बड़ी शर्मा पति महारी जय जय सीताराम डिवोटीज शुभ स्वागतम A most cordial welcome to you tonight, to the second night of Shiv Puran Yajna, devotion to that most benevolent Lord, Sadashiv Bhagwan, where we have the wonderful opportunity, my dear friends, as we did last night, to delve into the pages of Shiva Mahapuran, extracting the wonderful divine charitra of Sadashiv Bhagwan. At this point in time, खड़ा हो जाए लेट्स ऑल स्टैंड लेट्स जॉइन टुगेदर इन शंकर भगवान जी की आरती
साजं च वर्षितं युक्तं वहिनायोजितं मय दीपं ग्रहान देवस्य त्रैलोक्यं तिमिरापहम् जय शिव ओंकारा हर शिव ओंकारा
जय शिव ओंकारा
जय शिव ओंकारा हर शिव ओंकारा
जय शिव ओंकारा
ब्रह्मा विष्णु सदा धारी
so simple to have devotees as we receive the blessings of Lord Shiva. श्री गजानंद स्वामी की श्रीमापति महादेव की पवन सुत हनुमान की श्री वृंदावन बिहारी लाल की बोलो भाई सब संजन की जय सियापति रामचंद्र की जय आसन लीजिए काइंडली बी सीटेड डिवोटीज ऑफिशिएटिंग पुजारी पंडित पंडित सुरेंद्र महाराज श्रोतागण भक्तजन डिवोटीज ऑफ गॉड. Once again tonight, on behalf of the management committee here at the Sri Ganesh Mandir, let me extend to you a very special welcome to the second night Shiv Puran Yagya, as we have this wonderful opportunity, my dear friends, to expand the wonderful knowledge that we have of Lord Shiva. And of course, we source this knowledge from the pages of Shiva Puran Katha. And as we prepare ourselves tonight for devotion, let us firstly join together in dhyana, in meditation, as we prepare to receive the divine charitra, the divine glories of Lord Shiva. And so where we sit, we assume a most comfortable posture. As we close our eyes and bring to our minds that most wondrous, beauteous form of Sadashiv Bhagwan. He Shiva Shankar, he Deen Dayalu, O All Merciful Lord. Tonight as we come together in this beautiful Yagya Shalai, we do so with one common purpose, and that is to render unto you, O Prabhu, our prema, our bhakti, our love and devotion. Bless us this night to the successful completion of our devotions here this evening. And through your divine blessings, enable us to receive and to understand the wonderful lessons enshrined for us within the pages of Shiv Puran Katha. And so as we focus our thoughts and energies in this manner, we now blend our voices together as we pay respects to Bhagwan in his manifold manifestations.
सरस्वत्यै नमः श्री गुरु चरण कमले भ्यो नमो नमः ओम प्रणम्य शिरसा देवम् कृपासन स्मरे नित्यम आयुः कारित सिद्धये विद्यारम्भे विवाहे च प्रवेशे निर्गमे तथा संग्रामे संसते चैव विघ्नतस्य न जायते ओम श्वेत परमासनं देवं श्वेत पुष्पोपाशोभिनं श्वेतांबर धरं नित्यं श्वेत गंधनोलेपनं ज्ञानमूलं गुरुर्मूर्ति पूजमूलं गुरुर्परम मंत्रमूलं गुरुर्वाक्यं मोक्षमूलं गुरुर्परम अध्यांतरहिते देवी आदिशक्ति महेश्वरी योग चै योग संभूते महालक्ष्मी नमस्तुते भद्रकाली नमो नित्यं सर्वे शक्ति स्वरूपिणी जगत्स्थिते जगन्माता नारायणी नमस्तुते नागेन्द्रहाराय त्रिलोचनाय भस्मांगरागाय महेश्वराय नित्याय सुधाय दिगंबराय तस्मै नकाराय नमः शिवाय मनुजवं मारुत तुल्य वेगं जितेन्द्रियं बुद्धिमतां वरिष्ठं वातात्मजं वानरयूथमुख्यं शिरामदूतं शरणं प्रपद्ये नीलाम्भुजं श्यामलकोमलाङ्गं सीतासमारुपतिभां भाग्यम् पानु महासायक चारुचापं नमामि रामं रघुवंशनाथं या देवी सर्वभूतेषु दुर्गारूपेण संस्थितः नमस्तस्य 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 नमो नमः या देवी सर्वभूतेषु शक्तिरूपेण संस्थिता नमस्तस्य 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 नमो नमः या देवी सर्वभूतेषु मातृरूपेण संस्थिता नमस्तस्य 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 नमो नमः नमस्तस्य नमो नमः नमस्तस्य नमो नमः ॐ शान्ति 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 हरि
We begin tonight by glorifying Shri Hanuman Swami. Ashta Siddhi Navanidhi Kedata. Hanuman Ji is described in the pages of Hanuman Chalisa as that manifestation of Shankar Bhagwan. As a matter of fact, we are told in the Ramayana Katha that at the time of Ram Avatar, Lord Brahma had given an instruction to the devatas, and he said to them, taking the form of the Vanar, you would accompany the Lord Sri Ramchandra on his mission on earth to destroy the Rakshasas. And so at that point in time, many of the devatas had taken various manifestations, including Sadashiv Bhagwan, who manifested, my dear friends, as Pavan Putra Hanumanji, to assist the Lord Sri Ramchandra in the destruction of the Rakshasas. And as you would know, Hanuman Swami was quite instrumental in the destruction of Kar and Dushan, of Ahiravan, of Ravan himself. Of course, we know Ahiravan was the one who took Sri Ram and Lakshman to Patal Lok. And Hanuman Swami, my dear friends, had assumed Panchmukhi Hanuman, the form of Sri Hanuman Swami with the five faces. And he descended into Patal Lok, my dear friends, to destroy Ahiravan and to free Sri Ramchandra and Lakshman, who were being held as prisoners of Ahiravan in Patal Lok. And so he was quite instrumental, my dear friends. He played quite a significant role together at the side of Bhagwan Sri Ramchandra in bringing an end to the scourge of wickedness that the Rakshasas posed upon the face of this earth, freeing the sons and the sadhus, the rishis and munis, who were being held, my dear friends, against their will at the hands of the demons.
Siddhi Sadhana Anand Karni Mangalamur Nidhan Lakshman Aur Tulsidas Sahit Ramchandra Bhagavan Bandau Paar Dhari Dharni Sis Mahavir Hanuman बल बुद्धि विद्या दीजिए निज चरणन हनुमान अरे राम भय व्याकुल सुनो हनुमान अरे राम भय व्याकुल सुनो हनुमान हो राम भय व्याकुल सुनो हनुमान सुनो हनुमान लक्ष्मण मारा हूँ हम मर गए थे सिया सुनीच जी प्राण सिया सुनीच जी प्राण लक्ष्मण मारा हूँ हम मर जाए के सिया सुनीच जी प्राण इतनी आज दुनहु पवन सुत इतनी आज दुनहु पवन सुत इन मूर्ति जीव प्राण राम भय व्याकुल सुनो हनुमान अरे राम भय व्याकुल सुनो हनुमान बैर सुशेर काहे रघुनंदन लक्ष्मण राम प्राण लक्ष्मण राम प्राण
बैर सुशेन कहे रघुनंदन लक्ष्मण राखी प्राण वे लक्ष्मण वाज शॉट बाय मेघनाथ ही फेल अनकॉन्शियस अपॉन द बैटल फ्लोर It is Hanuman ji who was sent to get that moon Sajivan in order to revive Lakshman. Even the Lord of the universe, Sri Ramchandra himself, was distressed when he saw the unconscious Lakshman lying upon the ground. It is Hanuman ji who came, my dear friends, to the assistance of Bhagwan Sri Ramchandra. Similarly, when we call out to him, he responds to us as well. My dear friends, removing all adversities and difficulties from our path.
सुशेन कहे रघुनंदन लक्ष्मण राखी प्राण लक्ष्मण राखी प्राण तुलसीदास भजु भगवान तुलसीदास भजु भगवान देखी वीर सुजान राम सुनो हनुमान अरे राम भय व्याकुल सुनो हनुमान सुनो हनुमान सुनो हनुमान सुनो हनुमान राम भय व्याकुल सुनो हनुमान अरे राम भय व्याकुल सुनो हनुमान अरे राम भय व्याकुल सुनो
Prem Simran Shri Pavan Putra Hanuman Ki Jai. Last night we started looking at the 108 names of Lord Shiva. In fact, those of us who were here last night would have listened to the first 20 names of Lord Shiva and the meanings of those names. And so we're going to look at 20 names again. Of course, let me remind you, Shiva Mahapuran lists 1,008 names of Lord Shiva. We are extracting 108 from the 1,008 names of Shankar Bhagwan. The 21st name, number 21, Vishesh, it means he is the Lord of the universe. 22, Shanti, which means peace. Every time we conclude by saying Om Shanti, 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 we are also taking the name of Lord Shiva. Number 23, Grahapati, which means he's the Lord of your home. Install that picture of Shankar Bhagwan at some part of your home. Some people put it at the entrance to their home, at the entrance to the mandir, even if it is not at the entrance, my dear friends, in some
some part in your puja room, in your mandir, whatever part of the home, that murti, a picture of Lord Shiva, must be there. And you know, my dear friends, we emphasize always, it is not just about putting the picture or the murti there, but what do you do with the picture? Is it just an adornment for the wall, another wall plaque or decoration? Most importantly, you offer a flower, you offer arati, you offer chandan, worship, puja must take place, my dear friends. And then, of course, he becomes really the Lord of the home, and to protect that home and that household. 24, Hara, which means he is the Lord of the mountain. Of course, he is Kailashpati. He resides upon Kailash Parvat. And so when we refer to him as Hara, he is the Lord of the mountain. Girish, another name which is synonymous with him being the Lord of the mountain. 26, Brahma Jyoti, or the brilliance of the supreme Brahman. That supreme Brahman, my dear friends, represents that cosmic energy from which you and I have come. Chidananda Rupaha Shivoham Shivoham. Chidananda Rupaha Shivoham Shivoham. You are consciousness and bliss. You are Shiva. You are Shiva. I am Shiva. What is Lord Shiva really saying to us? He's saying all of us are Shiva. If he is described as Brahma Jyoti, or the brilliance of the supreme Brahman, my dear friends, and he's saying to us, Chidananda Rupaha Shivoham Shivoham, within all of us, my dear friends, that divine spark of energy, that consciousness of Shiva resides within all of us. It means essentially we are spiritual entities. Sometimes, my dear friends, we allow ourselves to become shrouded by the Maya and the materialism of this world, shrouding or covering that latent spiritual energy, my dear friends, symbolized by Brahma Jyoti. Number 27, Chaturved, which means he also represents the four Vedas. He possesses the knowledge of the four Vedas. Sarva Swarup, he is omnipresent. Ishvara Sarva Bhutana, wherever you go, Shankar Bhagwan is with you. The devotees went looking for Lord Shiva. They said, we have to go to Kailash Parvat to find Lord Shiva. And the rishis and muni says, nahi, no. He is here with you now. Whilst his abode is upon Kailash Parvat, my dear friends, that Lord resides there, yet he is with all of us. And so is he is with us here now, tonight at this mandir. And when each and every one of us return to our homes tonight, he also returns with us. But you know what makes a difference, my dear friends? For that individual, for that devotee who recognizes this, who understands this, and who lives as though Lord Shiva is really with them. Because the average devotee ignores Bhagwan Shankar. He is with you, yes, but do you recognize him at all times? Do you recognize him upon waking up in the morning? Jai Shiva Shankar, Jai Bholena. Do you recognize him during the course of the daytime? Do you recognize him at the night time? This, my dear friends, is the requirement to understand Sarva Swarup. He is with us, my dear friends, all the time, every single moment of the day. And when we recognize that, my dear friends, then of course we'll feel his presence. But if we discard him and ignore him, then obviously, my dear friends, we would never feel his divine presence. Number 29, Niranjan. Niranjan means spotless. He who is unblemished. We, my dear friends, you know, as we go along in life due to negative actions, negative karma, we begin to develop spots on that clean white chadar. Meli chadar odh ke kaise, meli chadar odh ke kaise, dwar tumhara हरे राम। हे पावन परमेश्वर मेरी मन ही मन शर्माऊं, मेली चादर ओढ़ के कैसे। सो वी ट्राई टू बी निरंजन एज वेल, we try to be spotless as well, my dear friends. That charar, which represents this body, was clean and pure and spotless at the time of birth, but as we progress through life, my dear friends, many kalank or spots, my dear friends, begin to blemish this charar, which represents the negative or bad karma. Number 30, the 30th name, Devindra. What we would say, Devindra. Devindra means he is the lord of the devatas. He's a supreme amongst all the devatas. Number 31, Sarvesh, lord of the entire universe. Number 32, Paramasan, he who is lotus seated. Of course, whenever you look at the Murti of Lord Shiva, he sits in Paramasan, or the lotus posture. Number 33, Varda, which means he's the bestower of boons. Indeed, that Lord is described as being the fulfiller of all goals and desires of his devotees when he is pleased with our sincere and genuine devotion. And the words you must note carefully, sincere and genuine devotion. When he is pleased with such devotion, you have different types of devotion, you know. You know, you have devotion that is performed with bhav and bhakti. You know, with utmost devotion and sincerity. You know, and then there's devotion that is performed with abhiman. You know, to show, my dear friends, always the simplest and the sincerest of devotions will be accepted by Bhagwan Sadashiv. So Varada means he's the bestower of all boons. Number 34, he is also called Nandishwar, which means he is the lord of Nandi. Nandi, of course, is one of the ganas or the attendants of Lord Shiva upon Kailash Parvat. 35, Anant means he is infinite. He's infinite, unlimited, my dear friends, unlike us. We are finite. We are limited in our powers and capability. But the divine Lord Shankar Bhagwan is anant, or infinite, limitless. 36, Shambhu. He's the bestower of wealth. 37, Trayambak, which means he has three eyes. We have three eyes as well, but the third eye is dormant. Lord Shiva, his third eye, my dear friends, you know, when he opened that third eye and looked at the Rakshasas, they were burnt to ashes. This is the power of the third eye, that stream of energy, my dear friends, that flows through that third eye. And so we too have that third eye, but it remains dormant. And the only way it can be activated or awakened, my dear friends, is through constant devotion to Lord Shiva. Number 38, he is also called Bhushan, which means that one who is ornamented or beautifully decorated. Number 39, Amrityu. Amrityu means deathless. He who is unborn will not die. That Lord Shankar Bhagwan is Amrityu. He was not born, and so he is not subjected to death, old age, sickness, as you and I are subjected to death and old age and sickness. Number 40, Loknath, the ruler of all the lokas. Mrityu Lok, Vaikunth Lok, Pata Lok, all the lokas, my dear friends. Sadashiv Bhagwan is described as Loknath, the ruler of the various lokas. And so tomorrow again we will continue examining the names and the meanings of the names.
You see, when you just read the names without the meanings, my dear friends, we do not get a full understanding of what these names really mean and the power of these names.
आओ महिमा गाए भोलेनाथ की भक्ति में खो जाए भोलेनाथ की
And this bhajan continues to tell us of the names of Lord Shiva. Of course, we all know he is called Bholenath. Bholenath ki jai, Shambhunath ki jai. That's another name, Shambhunath. Gaudinath ki jai, Dinanath ki jai. Yes, Gaudinath, Dinanath. All of these, my dear friends, are the names of Lord Shiva. And so it says, O devotee, sing, glorify that divine Lord in his various forms and manifestations.
Aavo mahima gaye Bholenath ki bhakti me kho jaye Bholenath ki Aavo mahima gaye Bholenath ki bhakti me kho jaye Bholenath ki Bholenath ki jai Shambhunath ki jai Gaurinath ki jai Dinanath ki jai Aao mahima gaaye Bholenath ki Bhakti mein kho jaaye Bholenath ki
प्रेम से बोले श्री भोलेनाथ महाराज की जय And now we turn our attention to the Katha tonight. We continue to immerse our thoughts upon that most benevolent form of Sadashiva Bhagwan as we now read the sacred lines from the pages of Shiva Mahapuran.
शिवाय नम शिव शिवाय नम शिव शिवाय नमो नम शिवाय शिवाय नम शिव शिवाय नम शिव शिवाय नमो नम शिवाय शिवाय नम शिव शिवाय नम शिव शिवाय नम शिव शिवाय नम शिव शिवाय नमो नम शिवाय शिवाय नमो नम शिवाय
सुत जी महाराज बोले हे मुनीश्वर This beautiful katha was narrated firstly by Sutaji Maharaj to Shaunak Muni and the other 88,000 rishis and munis in the name Isharanya forest. You and I, my dear devotees, have the wonderful opportunity to share in this divine narration.
अब हम नरजेश्वर अवतार के वर्णन करते हैं जिसने उस मुनि ब्राह्मण का दुख दूर किया है व्याघ्र पर जो तप में प्रसिद्ध हो जाते हैं उसके एक पुत्र उपजा जिसका नाम उपमुनि रखा गया वहां सदा अपने मातुल के घर माता सहित रहता है भाग्यवश दरिद्रता ने आघोर तपस्या संयोग में एक दिन उपमुनि में दूध पिया के
उसके पीने से और अधिक दूर पीने की इच्छा हुई। उन्होंने हठ से बार बार अपनी माता से दूर मांगा था, सो दरिद्रता के कारण दूर को ठिकाना कहा था। उसने यह कूद पानी में घोल दूर में ओधर में उपनी का पिला दिया है। उपमुनि से उसे पीकर कहा के यह दूर नहीं है, यह कहकर वहां रोने और बार बार अपनी माता में दूर मांगने लगा। निधान उसने दुखी हो उपमुनि से कहा कि तो अपने भाग्य से महा अधीन हूँ, मैंने पूर्व जन्म में शिवजी भगवान मित्र कुछ दान नहीं देता है। शिवाय नमः शिव शिवाय नमः शिव शिवाय नमो नमः शिवाय सब कोई शिवाय नमः शिव शिवाय नमः शिव शिवाय नमो नमः शिवाय शिवाय नमः शिव शिवाय नमः शिव शिवाय नमः शिव शिवाय नमः शिव शिवाय नमो नमः शिवाय शिवाय नमो नमः शिवाय। प्रेम से बोले विष्णु महापति महादेव की जय। In the village of Narajeshwar, there lived the wonderful Brahman whose name was Vyagrapar. He desired to have a son. And so, in consultation with the Guru, himself and his Dulahin performed devotion to Lord Shiva. Very simply, they were given the Panchakshad Mantra to chant. Everybody knows the Panchakshad Mantra. It consists of 5 syllables. Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. They were given these instructions by the Guru to perform devotion to Sadashiva Bhagwan, utilizing this mantra, and this they did. My dear friends, in due course of time, that son that they desired was born to them. Vyagrapar named this child Upmuni. They were very happy, but they were very poor households. After the mother stopped nursing, they did not have enough money, my dear friends, to buy milk to feed to the young child, Upmuni. And so what she would do, she would grind rice and, you know, mix it in water, dissolve it in water, and this she would feed to the child, Upmuni. He drank this milk, my dear friends, satisfied at least, you know, he was getting something, you know, to bring nutrients and strength to his growing body. One day they were invited to his mamu's home for puja. And of course, Vyagrapar and his Dulahin and the young child Upmuni attended this puja. During the course of the puja, he became very hungry. The young child, Upmuni, wanted something to eat or something to drink. And so the mother took some milk from that home, that's her brother's house, and she gave it, she fed it to Upmuni. And you know, he had become so accustomed, my dear friends, with the taste of the rice, the grind rice, and the water that she would dissolve in the water and feed to him. On that day he said, Ma, this milk is tasting so nice. Why don't you always give this milk to me at home? And she promised him that day that yes, she would do so. And this is a simple request from a child, you know, and no mother would like to be put in a position where she cannot give to the child a simple thing as the milk that he requests of her. And so when they returned home, he said, Ma, I am hungry. I need some milk. And she did not have milk. Remember, they were very poor people. Vyagrapar and his wife were very poor individuals. And so she went back to grinding the rice, my dear friends. She ground the rice, and that grind rice she dissolved in the water once more. And she was feeding this to him. But he started to cry. He says, I don't want this milk anymore. Of course, having tasted the sweetness of milk itself, the pure milk, he does not want to go back to drinking this, you know, diluted grind rice and milk, you know. So he's crying. He says, I will no longer drink this that you're feeding to me. I want that sweet milk that you gave me at my mamu's home. She herself started to cry. The mother is now crying because now she's put in a, you know, a very terrible predicament, my dear friends. Here her son is crying for milk and she does not have that to give to him. So she calls to her husband. Vyagyapar, our son desires to have milk. And he's asking, why can't we not feed him the milk that was given to him at his mamu's home? And so the father is now explaining, mother and father both are explaining to the crying child, Beta, we are very poor people. And you know, for some of us, it might be difficult to conceptualize how a family could be so poor that they can't feed the child, you know, the basic necessities such as milk. My dear friends, there are parts of the world right now where not just one or 10 or 100, but thousands of children are starving. If you look at the country called Yemen, if you ever look at the news, you would see the children, my dear friends, all the bones are showing in their bodies. They don't have milk, they don't have food, they don't even have medicines. Hundreds of children are dying every day. And that's just one example I'm giving you. If you follow what is happening globally, worldwide, my dear friends, there are many, many countries where children, where people are starving on a daily basis. So whilst here in Trinidad, it might be difficult to understand how a family could be in such a situation. For here, we eat and we have enough to throw away, isn't it? But my dear friends, amongst us, living in this world, there are many, many people who don't even have one meal to eat for the day. And this family that we're reading of, Vyagrapad Muni and his family, is one such family. So he's saying, Beta, we are very poor. We do not have the means to have a cow or to even buy the milk from someone who have a cow. And you know, thousands of years ago, you didn't have the avenue open to go to the grocery or the parlor to purchase powdered milk. All the milk came from the cow. As a matter of fact, those who are old enough would remember a time, maybe 50, 60 years ago, if you didn't have a cow, you didn't have milk to drink. Simple as that, you know. For you did not have the availability of powdered milk and packed milk and canned milk and so on as we have today. So this is what the father is explaining to the son. We do not have a cow and we do not even have money to buy milk from someone who owns a cow. And this is why you cannot have that sweet tasting milk that you had when you went to that puja at your mamu's home. But the little boy is thinking, and so he asked his father, Pitaji, tell me then, why do others have an abundance of milk and all other necessities, and why do we as a family live in this particular situation of poverty and hunger? And that's a very important question, my dear friends. If you look around, you are going to see disparities, differences, you know, in living standards and living conditions and so on. Why is this so? Why is it that everyone cannot be, my dear friends, provided equally all the necessities that they desire? And so the father says to him, and we're going to get the answer here, in our purva janam, the father is speaking to his son and to his dulahin. In the purva janam, all of us had one thing in common. We failed to give andan. On account of our failure to give andan, and andan is the gift of food. You know, there are five forms of dan that we're supposed to give. Andan is one, the gift of grains, the gift of food. Of course, when you perform puja, you offer the grains upon the bedi, you offer the grains in the sidha. There's dakshina dan, the gift of money. You offer upon the Bedi, you give to Baba Dakshina as well. There's Vastradan, the gift of clothing. You offer the cotton on the Bedi, representative of clothing. And of course, when you Sankalp your Chandi, you also put articles of clothing there. There's Sonadan, the gift of gold. There's Gaudan, the gift of the cow. Five forms of Dan. So the father is saying to the son, in our Purvachanam, none of us gave Andan. On account of that, we suffer together as a family through poverty and hunger. Have you ever wondered, my dear friends, why your family is constituted, is made up in the way it is made up? In other words, why do you have the children that you have and no other children? By what process? What system is used to determine? Is it a, you know, you have a lottery system sometimes, people want to get a home, NHA home, or a lot of land, and there's a lottery system to pull a number to see which home or which lot you're going to get? Is it a lottery system? Is it a lock and chance system? Nahi, my dear friends, none of those. It is determined through common karmic background. People of similar karma are put together in one household as one family. In other words, Bhagavan is not going to take someone in their Purvachanam who lived the life of a Mahabhakta, always coming to the mandir, always performing puja, listening to katha, and you know, all the other activities of devotion, and put him in the home of someone who in the Purvachanam always take the bottle of daru. Oh no, you know, of alcohol, who never made time for Bhagavan. Because such an individual, my dear friends, is going to be born with certain distinct characteristics, my dear friends, that would continue. You see, we must understand, we are actually continuing from where we have left off in the Purvachanam. Bhagavan has given to us, my dear devotees, another opportunity to accomplish that which we fail to accomplish in the Purvachanam. And this is what the father, Vyagrapar Muni, is explaining to his sons. In our Purvachanam, none of us ever engaged in Andan. On account of that, we have been placed together in this family, in order to overcome the consequences of the karma of the Purvachana. My dear friends, we have something in common with Vyagrapar Muni and his family. We too. Are experiencing, we too are harvesting the effects of the karma from the Purvachanam. Obviously, when there is good karma, there are good consequences and experiences. And needless to say, if there is bad karma, there are bad consequences and experiences. We shall find out after this bhajan what they do. What did they do, my dear friends, to overcome the negative effects of their karma?
Mati kahe kuhar se, tu kya rondhe moh, ek din aisa aayega. So
As in the case of Vyagrapad and his family. What is accountable for the distinction, the difference? Aye hai so jayega, we enter into this world, some as millionaires, some as beggars. But when we leave this world, my dear friends, we all leave empty-handed. We take along only with us the punya, the good karma, the blessings derived from puja and yajna. This becomes the greatest wealth of that individual. Mahadeva ki.
So the young child, Upmuni, was just about 5 years of age when this incident took place, you know. So the father has given the explanation, we are living in this condition because of the karma from the Purvajana. And Upmuni's response was, Lord Shiva always responds to his devotees. I, Upitaji, will seek the blessings of Lord Shiva to overturn, to overcome the negative effects of our karma from the Purvajanam. And that's very important. You know, sometimes people reach a stage of helplessness and hopelessness. They say, Baba, it's karma. What I could do? I have to live like this. Nahi. No. Bhagwan always leaves that doorway open, my dear friends, for us to redeem ourselves. We must be positive thinking as this child is thinking in this positive manner. He always gives us that opportunity, my dear friends, to overcome, to rise above whatever situations or trials and tribulations that may be placed in our pathway in life. And so he leaves his home, he goes to Kailash Parvat, and he begins to worship Lord Shiva. He sits beneath a bale tree. He takes a handful of mud from the nearby stream, and he makes a little Shivlingam. And now he begins to recite the Panch Akshar Mantra. You know, sometimes we believe that we must know the... Now, it's good if you know the longer Sanskrit mantras. But if you do not know these longer mantras, do not believe that you are at a disadvantage. Here we are seeing again the power of the Panchakshara mantra. A mantra that is so simple. When the children now begin to speak, I have heard 2-year-olds, 3-year-olds say, Om Namah Shivaya. Here we are reading, my dear friends, the greatest of devotees are getting the darshan, receiving the blessings of Lord Shiva by using that one mantra, Om Namah Shiva. It is always a distressing thing to hear a Hindu say, I don't know what to say, I don't know how to pray. Even the smallest child could say, Om Namah Shivaya. And this child is going to receive darshan of Lord Shiva by chanting that one mantra. Encourage the children. What's the age of this child, Upmuni? He's 5 years old. Sometimes you say, Baba, the child too small as yet. Give them a chance to grow big. And by the time they grow big and become a teenager, then they don't want to come and sit with you at the bedi and perform puja. Then they don't want to come to you, come with you to the mandir, to the yajna. But when you inculcate in them, my dear friends, you see we have two nice little children here sitting with the daddy in puja. When you inculcate in them from a young age, my dear friends, the importance of puja, that practice grows with them. And so, my dear friends, when they become an adult, you don't have to force them, you don't have to coax them, you know, to come. They are coming on their own. They are voluntarily coming, my dear friends, instead of being forced to come. So he is chanting that mantra, and the very first time he chants Om Namah Shivaya, Parvati Mata says to Lord Shiva, and where are they? They are upon Kailash Parvat. The very first time he chants Om Namah Shivaya, Parvati says, Prabhu, look at this young child. Look at the sincerity of his devotion. Look at the power of his chanting. And what makes the chanting powerful, devotees? Not how hard you chant it, you know, or how loud you chant the mantra. The bhava and the bhakti. The purity and the sincerity. This child, my dear friends, was untainted. He was untainted, my dear friends, by greed and anger and jealousy and lust and abhimana and so on. This is what dilutes or weakens, undermines, my dear friends, the power of our devotion. You could sit down and chant whole day, you know. But if you're chanting and you're angry, you are diluting the returns, the blessings you're going to get. If you're chanting and you know your mind's supposed to be on Lord Shiva, but you're thinking about the food you're going to eat afterwards, you are diluting, my dear friends, the blessings that you're going to attain. It must always be sincere, genuine, and untainted. And a child's mind and heart is always pure and untainted. The 5-year-old, my dear friends, is not affected by greed and anger and lust and so on, as the adults tend to be. So we purge our minds of these, my dear friends, and so we will attain the same reaction. Parvati Mata, the first time he chanted Om Namah Shivaya, she says, Prabhu, look at this child. Look at the power of his chanting. We must go to him. We must give him his blessings. We must appear to him and give darshan to him, Prabhu. And Lord Shiva says to her, Devi, be patient. Nothing happens before time. When the time is right, we will deliver on to Upmuni the blessings that he deserves. That applies to us as well. Sometimes we offer one lota jal and we expect next morning Bhagwan is going to fix all that is wrong in our lives. Everything happens in time. The words of Lord Shiva, when the time is right, Uparvati, Upmuni would receive the blessings that he deserves. When the time is right for us as well, my dear friends, Bhagwan monitors, he witnesses all that we do. And when he is pleased with our devotion, my dear friends, over a passage of time, then of course he is going to deliver unto us the fullness of our blessings. And so, after some time, he says, Parvati, let us go. We are going to Upmuni, to this little child. Lord Shiva takes the form of Indra. And Parvati Mata says, what are you doing? He says, Devi, you must take the form of Indrani. And this she does. But why are we doing this, O Prabhu? We must test him, O Devi, to determine the sincerity of his devotion. Throughout our lives, my dear friends, we are tested. When the children are in school, they have to write C exam to go on to secondary school. When they have to go from secondary school to university or to CAPE, again they have to write exams. And even during the term, they're writing exams. When you have to drive a motor car, you have to pass a driving test. Then you can drive on the road. Bhagwan Shankar is saying to Parvati, we must put him to a test. We must test him to see if he is really sincere in what he is doing. So they appear before Upmuni as Indra and Indrani, not as Lord Shiva and Parvati. So Lord Shiva speaks to him in the disguise of Indra. He says, Upmuni, I am pleased with your devotion. Ask for whatever varadhan you desire and I will bestow this onto you. And Upmuni says, he opens his eyes and he sees Indra. He pays his respects to him and he says, O Indra, while I am very happy that you came here, I will continue my devotion until my Lord Shiva comes. And Lord Shiva says, still in the disguise of Indra, haven't you heard, Upmuni, that Lord Shiva has lost all his powers? What you are doing here, you will not get any blessings from Lord Shiva. Right now, he needs some blessings himself. Turn away from him and worship me instead. That sound familiar, devotees? Sometimes people would come to you at your home and they would say the very same thing. Turn away from what you are doing and to whom you are praying and turn somewhere else and then you will get blessings. But the true devotee, the true bhakta, my dear friends, is never deterred. He never wavers and weakens in his belief to God. And so Upmuni took some water from the kamandal that he had nearby and he held it in his hand and he said to Indra, at least Lord Shiva, still in the disguise of Indra, if you speak against my Lord in this manner, O Indra, I will pronounce a shrap upon you and you will lose your ability to speak. My dear friends, it is a terrible sin to sit idly by and listen to your dharma, to your religion being desecrated or insulted in any manner. This is the wonderful teachings, my dear friends, in Shiv Puran Katha tonight. Do not speak against my Lord Shiva in this manner. I will not allow you to do so, O Indra. Yet, my dear friends, some of us allow people to come into our own homes and ill speak, desecrate our religious belief, our parents, our grandparents, my dear friends. This is a terrible travesty. This is a terrible injustice, my dear friends, that we perpetrate upon ourselves and those who have gone before us. Let us understand, it is not just about us. It is about those, our parents, grandparents, great-grandparents who have come before us and who have placed in our hands this wonderful Sanatan Dharma which we cherish and take forward. And when Lord Shiva saw, my dear friends, you know, the sincerity and the power, the steadfast nature of his devotion, what did he do? He appeared now in Shivadu. That form of Sadashiv Bhagwan, my dear friends, he now revealed to Upmuni. And Parvati Mata, of course, revealed that form of Devi Parvati to Upmuni. And what did he do? My dear friends, for a little while he could not do anything. He gazed in awe and wonder at this divine form, this benevolent form of Lord Shiva and Devi Parvati Mata. And finally, coming to his senses, he started to glorify Bhagwan. He paid his respects to Lord Shiva. And Shankar Bhagwan bestowed upon him that varadan. Return to your home, O Upmuni. Never again would you or your family have to be deficient in any way, lacking in any way. All necessities would be bestowed upon you. And furthermore, when your time have expired on this earthly planet, O Upmuni, you yourself would ascend into my heavenly abode.
शिव शंकर रखवाला मेरा शिव शंकर रखवाला मेरा शिव शंकर रखवाला मेरा शिव शंकर रखवाला शिव शंकर रखवाला मेरा शिव शंकर रखवाला मेरा शिव शंकर रखवाला मेरा शिव शंकर रखवाला मंगलकारी नाम है उनका शंभु भोला भाला मेरा शिव शंकर रखवाला रखवाला मेरा शिव शंकर रखवाला
ऐसी दीन दयाला मेरा ऐसी दीन दयाला मेरा शिव शंकर रखवाला मेरा शिव शंकर रखवाला शिव शंकर रखवाला मेरा शिव शंकर रखवाला मेरा शिव शंकर रखवाला मेरा शिव शंकर रखवाला मेरा शिव शंकर रखवाला
That Lord is, is the protector of this entire universe and the protector, my dear friends, for each and every one of us. Mangalakari Namah Unka. He brings auspiciousness, success and happiness into our lives when we would glorify Him. At this point in time, khada ho jaye, let us all stand, so join together in Shankar Bhagwan Ji Ki Aarti.
आरती करो हर हर की करो नतवर की भोल शंकर की आरती करो शंकर की
Shiva. सब कोई लेट अस ऑल सिंग टुगेदर
ओम नमः शिवाय
ओम नमः शिवाय ओम नमः शिवाय
ओम नमः शिवाय
ओम नमः शिवाय बोलो बोलो सब मिल बोलो ओम नमः शिवाय शीश जटा में गंगा धारी त्रिशूल धारी डमरू बजाए शीश जटा में गंगा धारी त्रिशूल धारी डमरू बजाए
This brings us to an end of devotions. Let us bow our heads in this final prayer. We give thanks to our Divine Lord. Shiva Shankar Bhagwan, it's to show your blessings, O Prabhu, that you have come together tonight in the performance of this second night of devotion to your lotus-like feet. We pray this night that you place your protective hands upon us, O Lord. May you continue to safeguard us and protect us against all dangers and difficulties. With utmost reverence, O Prabhu, repeatedly surrender on to your lotus-like feet.
Mantrahinam kriyahinam bhaktihinam janadhanam yatpuchitam mayadevam paripurnam tadastune tvameva mata chapita tvameva त्वमेव बन्धुश्च सखा त्वमेव त्वमेव विद्या द्रविणं त्वमेव त्वमेव सर्वं मम देव देव ॐ शान्तिः 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 हरि ओम
प्रेम से बोलिए श्री गजानंद स्वामी की श्रीमावती महादेव की पवन सुत हनुमान की श्री वृंदावन बिहारी लाल की उड़ेसा जगन्नाथ की बोलो भाई सब संतन की सियापति रामचंद्र की कलेक्टिव इन अ लॉन्ग टू द वॉइस व्हिच आई एम पिक्चरिंग श्री सनातन धर्म श्री सत्य सनातन धर्म की जय जय सीताराम आसन लीजिए काइंडली बी सीटेड डिवोटीज
Our counselor in our midst this afternoon, Ms. Ramona Victor. She's the counselor for our area here, and I would call on her just to say a few words to us. Ms. Ramona Victor.
Good night, brothers and sisters. Are you hungry? Good night, brothers and sisters. Firstly, I must say thank you for your support, your continued support. for me being your counselor of Superior East San Francisco South. You know, today as the Baba spoke, it make me wonder, because you know, I often get that feeling, why are some kings and queens and others beggars? But Baba, as you said, we will all leave empty-handed. So, you know, that brings some form of resolution to what the thoughts that I usually have. So I will encourage those of you who are kings and queens to share it amongst the beggars so that we could all live a more happy life, a more successful life. I must say again that I am here to support this temple because I know that this temple has continuously support my political party. So I must add again that I am here for support wherever you need me. My office is at 275 San Francisco Road. My contact number is 343-8931. Thank you and enjoy the rest of the service.
Sangye Television is not only the first Hindi TV station in Trinidad and Tobago, but Sangye TV also has the most coverage. You can find Sangye Television on YouTube by searching for Sangye Television.